Hello, this is Hiroshi Yamazoe. This time, I will talk about the topic of hikikomori and the cost of living. I have mentioned about this topic several times in my previous videos, but this time I will talk about my thoughts on this topic again in a more organized and summarized way. Because I believe that this issue, hikikomori and financial situation, is very important and crucial. In this day, money is basically necessary for survival in any country. However, when you are a hikikomori, your ways to get money become very limited. Many of the people who come to my channel also mentioned this issue in their comments. It seems to be an important topic that many people are interested in. So in this time, I will try to talk about this topic. In this video, I'm gonna talk about two main points. First, my personal financial situation as a person who has experienced long-term severe hikikomori state. And second, I'm gonna talk about how hikikomori can earn their living expenses in a specific way. So first of all, I will talk about my personal financial situation. As I have said in other videos, I was living as a severe long-term hikikomori from my early teens until my early 20s. I finally got a job and became independent around the age of 24. But at that time, I was living in extreme poverty in a shabby apartment. After that, I got a job at an automobile company and worked in logistics department, and the salary was around 4 to 5 million yen per year. Through that job, I was able to save about 2 million yen per year. It is about 20,000 USD. This is how my financial situation gradually improved. And before I go on to say that, I don't generally recommend this to other people because of the risks involved. This is that I have been investing my savings in the stock market since that time when I was able to save money. I will talk more about this later, but I was fortunate that it worked out, and as a result, I now have enough money to live on my own for the time being. I was unable to get a proper school education due to bullying, and my parents neglected and abused me. But when I think from an economic point of view, I still feel privileged and fortunate because there are many people in the world who cannot save any money no matter how they work hard. I have traveled to Cambodia and Philippines in 2019 and know the environment that these people live in. In this aspect, I am very grateful for the blessings I have been given and feel that I should give back to the world in some way. And now, moving on to the next point. This is that how can a hikikomori earn their living expenses? In my opinion, there are five main ways. First, get it from your family. Second, get it from the government. Third, become an employee. Fourth, start your own business. Fifth, investment. I think these five methods are common throughout the world. I will talk about them one by one. The first method is to get money from your family. I think this is an orthodox method for hikikomori. And if your parents are rich, you may be able to get enough money from them. But I think very few people have such great parents or family members. The second method is to use the government system of the country you live in to get money for your living expenses. For example, in Japan, there is a welfare system that provides people who are in poverty with enough money to live for a minimum standard of living. However, the money you can get from this system is basically very small, and you can basically only do what you can do to survive at the minimum level, so you will be limited in what you can do from this. It will be difficult to buy a car or travel abroad, and so on. You can basically only have the basics for your living needs. In addition, I think this method is probably only available in economically privileged and developed countries. Poor countries may not have such a method, unfortunately, because social security is not sufficiently developed. In the case of such countries, which poor people cannot receive enough support from the government, maybe some religious or charitable organizations can help those who are in poor state. The third method is to break away from being a hikikomori and become an employee of a company. I think this is the most socially acceptable way, but often it is very hard to get out of the hikikomori state and get a job. It takes a lot of courage to get a job, especially for a person like me who has been severely hikikomori for a long time. However, although this method is hard, but I think it is also a simple way. This is because jobs are basically available in every country, and there is information, help, and support for job seekers as well. But the working environment and wages are very different in each country. In some cases, no matter how much you work hard, you may not be able to earn enough money for leave. In that case, I think changing your job or working abroad is an option. The fourth method is to start your own business and make money on your own. In this day and age, there are many ways to make money simply by using the internet and PC. For example, making videos, web pages, blog posts, photography, translation, programming, and so on. If you can create a source of income that can be fully generated by only through the internet, you can become financially independent even though you are a hikikomori still. But the problem with this method is that there is no certainty regarding the method of making money online. It can be no matter how hard you try, you may never get even single cent, Also, there is a lot of fake information on methods to make money on the internet. So the first thing you need to do is not to be deceived by such fake information. So this method probably requires you to use more brain and creativity and effort than working as an employee. Actually, I have tried a few different ways to earn income from the internet. The first is running a game news blog, and second is running a blog that translates, explains, and introduces overseas cloud services, such as cloud storage services and hosting services, and earns a fee based on the number of registered users through this site. The game blog only had about 300 views per month. No matter how hard I tried to update it every day, it was very little number of views. But the latter site that introduces overseas cloud services was getting about 80,000 to 120,000 views per month, and the reward was about 100,000 yen per month, which combined with Google AdSense, it is about $1,000. But the work of running this site was very painful. I was writing articles of about 5,000 characters every day. It was so painful, and one day I stopped running the site. What I learned from this experience is that if I work on something just for the purpose of making money, my motivation will not last. I learned that it is impossible to maintain motivation unless it is something I really want to do. I thought it would be ideal to combine what I want to do and making money. I also learned that it is not impossible to earn enough money online if I make full use of my abilities and make plans strategically and have patience. Anyway, I think it is worth the challenge to create online income source because it is so great to be able to achieve both personal freedom and financial independence. The fifth method is investment. This has a risk. There is a possibility of losing your money, so I don't generally recommend it to other people. But in my case, as I said before, I was investing in stocks, and the main part of my investment method was to purchase ETFs such as S&P 500 and VT and so on that increase in value in accordance with the growth of the world economy and accumulating them through reserve purchase and spot trading. This is a popular low-risk investment strategy based on the assumption that the world economy will continue to grow little by little in the future. This method basically does not make you a lot of money in the short term, but it also basically does not make you lose a lot of money too. On average, the money increases about 7% per year from this, and excluding inflation rate from it, the profit is about only 4% per year. But again, I'm not recommending investing in stocks. I'm just saying for reference that I do it with an understanding of the risks. And by the way, recently the word FIRE has become popular in the United States and Japan. FIRE means Financial Independence Retire Early. In essence, this idea is to work a lot at the company while you are young, and save a lot of money, and invest in ETFs like the S&P 500 that rise in accordance with the growth of the overall US economy, like I did. And once the amount invested in the ETFs accumulates to a certain level, quit the company, earn an average of 10% profit per year from that, and use the 4% profit that is deducted from the inflation rate to live freely without being bound by the company. I have been working on a smaller version of this for a long time. And in this strategy, in order to live on only 4% profit per year, you will need a lot of amount of investment. In Japan, you would probably need at least 30 million yen for this strategy. It is about 300,000 USD. Even then, in Japan, you would be living on very poor state. I think you need twice that amount to live a normal life in Japan with this strategy. But if you go abroad where the cost of living is cheaper, it may be different. And the problem with this strategy is that it is based on the assumption that the world economy will continue to grow at the same pace for a long time to come. But if there is a major economic crisis and the economy is down for decades and never comes back, this FIRE strategy will not work. But there are risks involved in simply saving money in the bank. As you probably know, every time inflation occurs, your savings will gradually decrease. For example, if one USD coke goes up to 1 USD and 10 cents, and the price of other things goes up in the same way, your savings will be the same as if you had lost 10%. Since the total number of issued currencies will continue to increase, inflation is basically the normal trend for currencies. Therefore, it is also a little risk to avoid investing too. So I think it is up to each individual to make a decision about it based on their own responsibility, considering the risks and benefits. And this is a little off topic, but in one of my old videos, I did a thought experiment about investing. It was a thought experiment on compound interest. As you may already know, compound interest is the interest that is added to interest. For example, if 100 USD increases by 1%, it will become 101 USD. And if that 101 USD increases another 1%, it will become $2 and $0.01. This 1 cent is compound interest. It is a very small amount, but when this compound interest is multiplied hundreds of times, something miraculous happens. For example, as I mentioned earlier, the average growth rate of the US economy, excluding inflation rate, is about 4% per year. Let's assume that this trend continues forever, and then buy $100 worth of an ETF that follows overall economic growth of the United States, such as the S&P 500. Then in 100 years, $100 will become $5,050, and in 200 years, it will become $255,075, and in 300 years, it will become $12,882,549, and this is the effect of compound interest. If you apply it 300 times over the 300 years, a mere 4% per year becomes about $100,000. I personally found this to be an interesting phenomenon. With this compound interest effect, it is possible for anyone to move up in the social hierarchy with just $100. But I know we can't live for 300 years. However, it may be possible to achieve this through your offspring or your friends. For example, if we create a group that buy 300 worth of ETFs and leave it for 300 years, and passes the account from generation to generation, it may be accomplished in 300 years. I think this is one specific and simple way for the poor people to have a chance to rise without being locked into poverty for the generations. So this time I have shared my thoughts on the how to hikikomori earn living expenses, and I also talked about some of the things that I came to mind along the topic and my own financial situation too. And by the way, you don't have to select just one of these five methods. You can mix them. In my case, I have lived by a combination of 3, 4, and 5. I think it's up to each person to find the method that suits them best. But in any case, I don't think money is everything. I believe that there are various kinds of happiness where money is not involved at all, such as enjoying nature, communicating with people, meditating, and so on. However, on the other hand, there is a hard reality that without money, we basically cannot survive. In today's world, capitalism covers most of the world, so in this time, I made a video on this topic. I hope if this can be helpful to you anyway. And I will continue to post a wide variety of videos more and more. If you are interested, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.